So I am Dr. Himanshu. I am the lead consultant in Department of Urology in Amandeep Medicity, Amritsar. I am also looking after the urology department in Amandeep Kamal Hospital in Tarantaran and also in Amandeep Hospital in Pathankot. So this topic for today, impact of COVID-19 on genitourinary tract disorders, it's a very important topic. You all know that coronavirus disease, it started in 2019 in Wuhan, China on 31st of December 2019, the first case was detected. And after that, it became a pandemic. And there are several variants that we have found for this virus. There was an alpha variant which was found in the UK, a beta variant in South Africa. Then there were travelers from Japan and the gamma variant was travelers from Brazil. And the gamma variant was found in Japan, and the Indian variants are the kappa and delta variant. Recently, in February 2021, there are two variants which were also found in the US. So why I'm telling you about all this, the reason is that this is a virus which keeps on mutating. It's been more than 1.5 years that the world is dealing with the virus now. And initially, the predominant organ that is involved by the virus is lungs. So that is the initial phase when initially the virus impacts the body. But after that, we have seen that due to this virus, the death rate is slightly lower as compared to other SARS viruses. This virus is also called the severe acute respiratory syndrome coronavirus 2, that is the SARS-CoV-2. So the death rate as compared to the previous SARS virus which was there, it is slightly less, but the infectivity is more. What that means is there are more number of patients who are recovering from the virus. More than 2.5 crore people have already recovered if we only talk in India. So due to this long stretch that now we have got, more than 1.5 years, what we see is that this virus has a delayed impact on other organs also. We have seen the heart getting involved. We have also noticed some patients who have gastrointestinal disease after recovery from the COVID virus. And in the same way, the genitourinary tract is also getting affected by this virus. And the patients are coming up with symptoms which can be attributed to this COVID virus only and the coronavirus disease or the infection that the patients got. So I am a urologist. I deal with the genitourinary tract. The genitourinary tract, it deals with kidney. There's a tube that comes out from the kidney, which is called the ureter. And then there's the bladder in which the urine is stored for some time before it is expelled out through the urethra. Genitourinary tract also consists of the male reproductive organs, the testes, the semen, the seminal vesicles, the prostate and the penis. So why should you be aware about the impact of COVID-19 on genitourinary tract? One thing is that we are all susceptible to SARS-CoV-2 even if we are vaccinated. And now we see that there are more number of patients who are recovering and getting these manifestations later on. So all of us who are having, it impacts the young, the middle age, as well as the elderly. And we all have kidneys and reproductive tract, and the times that we are living right now, it's very imminent that it can impact more number of people. We have already seen the first wave and the second wave, which is slightly on the downfall right now. But we don't know. We have to prepare for the third wave, and we have to prepare ourselves into the whole kind of panorama of this COVID virus disease, which is involving other organs now. So if you talk about the kidneys, what we have seen is that patients who are affected with the coronavirus, 25% of them can have an acute kidney injury. Acute kidney injury means something which happens on a short time. The kidney injury can be chronic or acute. So when it is happening over a short time, that's called acute. And 25% of patients of COVID, they have their kidneys, which is impacted by this. We have also seen that 60% of these patients who have their kidneys involved can present with leakage of protein in their urine. And almost 50% of the patients can have blood in urine, which is called hematuria. So the risk factors for patients who can develop acute kidney injury, these are the patients who are already having a chronic kidney disease, or the patients who are diabetic or hypertensive, patients who are on dialysis, or the patients who have some cardiovascular disease for which they are already undergoing treatment. The next thing is lower urinary tract symptoms. First of all, let me tell you what is the lower urinary tract. The lower urinary tract is the bladder and the urethra, and there's a prostate in males. It is not there in females. So this is called the lower urinary tract. So whenever there are lower urinary tract symptoms, they can get worsened if the patient is having symptoms of increased frequency of urine. Normally, a patient urinates for around 8 to 10 times in a day, and usually not even once in the night. So if the patient has to get up repeatedly during the night to pass urine, or if you can see that there's a patient who's passing urine every 1 hour or every 2 hours, more than 20 times, 15 times a day, that is something that we need suddenly bring us on our toes, that there is something which is not right and it should be evaluated. Another symptom is that, you know, people can't hold urine. You got to go when you got to go. It's very difficult to hold urine, and the patient fear that if they try to control it, if they try to hold it, there can be a leakage of urine. So the risk group exaggeration of these lower urinary tract symptoms, these are the patients who are having an enlarged prostate, whose symptoms are already controlled on some medicines, but they have suddenly worsened after COVID. Or there are patients who are having some recurrent urinary tract infection. It happens over and over again, and suddenly they feel this thing that after COVID, they are feeling more burning in the urine, or they are having more lower urinary tract symptoms, what I told you. So this is something which should be evaluated. This is something which can very easily be neglected by the patients, thinking that they are already having such issues. Maybe they need to change medicine. They can think like that. So what I would suggest is, it's not right to wait with such symptoms. If you feel that your symptoms are getting deteriorated, you have to see your urologist and get them evaluated. As I told about the urinary tract infections, usually urinary tract infections, they are more common in women as compared to men. And usually they affect the elderly who are 16 and above. But after the second wave, we have seen that the number of young patients between the age group of 20 to 60 years, they are coming up with urinary tract issues. They are coming up with urinary tract infections. And, they are coming with symptoms of lower urinary tract symptoms, what I told you earlier. They can have a change in their color of urine, which can be red in color, or there can be frank blood in urine. And patients can feel burning or pain while they are urinating. So it is seen that after the second wave, some studies suggest that there is an increased incidence of COVID-19 associated cystitis, which means the infection in the bladder or inflammation of the bladder. And it's also been noted that the virus is detected in urine and the urine cytokine levels are elevated in patients who have recovered from COVID, and they become more prone to urinary tract infections. Last but not the least, there are reproductive and marital issues. Reproductive problems that can come up in patients are, they can be fertility struggles, they can be problems with physical intimacy, problems during sexual intercourse, there can be a lack of libido or a lack of intimacy between the partners. These are serious issues, and these can, these usually they turn into bedroom stories and nobody talks about it. But it's a huge issue. It can even lead to disruption of a healthy marriage. So if there are some patients with COVID who are feeling that, their reproductive, there's a lack of intimacy, or their reproductive behavior, or their, marital behavior has changed after COVID, that is something which should be evaluated. If you talk about the male reproductive tract, it can lead to inflammation or swelling in the testis, which is called viral orchitis. There have been reports where we have noted that there's a decreased testosterone to luteinizing hormone ratio. So testosterone to LH ratio can be decreased, and it can lead to a potential impairment of reproductive health. The clinical implication is that if there's a patient who's recovering from COVID or who has recovered for COVID, especially young men who are interested in having children, starting their family, they should receive a consultation regarding these reproductive issues. Then erectile dysfunction. Again, the age group is a younger age group, 25 to 55 years old patient. They can have issues with erection. They can have, this is in common language, it is called impotence. So if some patients who have recovered from COVID, if they feel that they are having such issues, then they should definitely consult a urologist. They should not ignore it. The at-risk population for this is the patients who have recovered from moderate to severe COVID. In all the reports that we have seen after mild COVID, mostly such issues are not seen. But if a patient has recovered from moderate to severe COVID, they can report such issues. More than that, there are some patients who have reported that even after vaccination, they have suffered these issues. So there is no scientific basis right now to say that vaccination leads to this. But if people are having such issues, they should come forward and they should tell it to your to their doctor so that it can be evaluated. The possible mechanisms, you know, that can lead to the erectile dysfunction. If there's a cytokine storm which happens in patients who are having severe COVID disease, and this can lead to damage in the vessels, which is called endothelial damage. There can be lack of oxygen due to pulmonary fibrosis. There can be psychological stress of COVID. And some people are having a dip in the hormone, which is called hypogonadism, and they can have such issues. If females were planning a pregnancy, if you know, there might be some people who have some females who have recovered from COVID, or they have had COVID infections during pregnancy. So what has been found is that symptoms are similar to non-pregnant females. There's no increased risk, but the drug treatment for COVID might be hazardous to the fetus as well as the pregnant female. The research is still going on. This is a newer thing which has come up. There are no clear answers. But as far as the reproductive societies around the world, if we go for their opinion, what they have proposed is that if a patient is planning for an artificial reproduction technique for conceiving, that means there are some females who are having the problems of infertility, and if they are planning IVF, that is in vitro fertilization, or IUI, that is intrauterine insemination. So they have proposed that the embryo transfer should be postponed because we don't have any clear guidelines right now. The options for such patients can be freezing their eggs or oocytes or embryos and opt for a delayed embryo transfer. Moreover, there's an impact on the management of kidney disease. What happens is, due to COVID and the lockdown which was there in place, many patients who are having urinary issues or kidney issues, they are not able to come to the doctor, they are not able to meet their doctor, and some treatments can be delayed, which can lead to increased cost of treatment and increased complications. Sometimes there's a guideline from the health regulatories that, you know, only the emergency treatment should go ahead. So some patients with kidney stones, if a stone falls down, that can be an emergency. That is a true urological emergency, and we need to take care of that. Many times patients think that, you know, patients know that they are having stone and they can have a change in their color of urine. They can have their pain in their back or pain in their abdomen. And what they do is that they go to the, you know, counters, the chemist shops, and they can take some painkillers. This should be avoided, because if a stone has fallen down and obstructed the ureter, then your kidney is at risk. Then there is a deterioration of renal function, which can happen later on, more so with the use of the painkillers which are readily available, you know, in the market. If we talk about cancers of kidney, bladder and prostate, this is a semi-emergency. So it's a war. It's a war. If, you know, any one side, on one side there's this cancer which is trying to encroach upon the patient's body, and on the other side there's a doctor and the patient who are trying to hold it or trying to cure it. So this, we have to be very aggressive in cancer treatment. If patients who are having cancers, who know that they have cancers, they should definitely consult their doctor that if they are waiting due to the present conditions, how long they should wait, how long is it safe to wait. And it should be a shared decision which should be taken on the behalf of doctor as well as the patient. So that is how the COVID virus, it impacts the genitourinary tract. The research is still going on. We may come up with certain other things which you know, can be further evaluated in the future. What I have shared with you is the impact that we have known till now. And I would like to tell you that I am a urologist, and a urologist is somebody who specializes in the care of urinary issues, and urine, it is formed in the kidney. So any urinary issues, however small it is, it can be an indication that something is wrong with the kidney, and you should not ignore your symptoms. You should seek the advice of a urologist to safeguard your kidneys as well as your marital health and your marital life. You are in good hands. Thank you.